Hey, I'm Josh. We're here at Rising Fawn Gardens. We're continuing with our spring wildflower tour, and we're working on some videos about black cohosh. There's a lot to say about this plant, but I wanted to focus in just a little bit more on some of the properties of the flower and some of the characteristics that it has. Black cohosh, unlike a lot of other flowers, doesn't have an especially great smell. In a way, it smells like carrion or decaying flesh to some people. But I think that people have different responses to the smell that it has. Because to me, the smell of black cohosh is not an unpleasant smell at all. It actually smells very much like grits. If you've ever cooked grits the long way, it has that kind of pleasant, earthy smell, and it's very much what black cohosh smells like to me. Black cohosh is not pollinated exclusively by bees, as some flowers are. Black cohosh, with its earthy smell, attracts ants, beetles, flies, and some bees. But what it doesn't attract is a lot of biting insects. And for this reason, you can take the flower, and once again, anytime I recommend that anybody gather anything, I just want to stress, if you're going to gather something, make sure it's abundant. Don't gather it from a place that it's rare or it might vanish altogether. We want to gather from an abundant stand. But if you were to gather it, you can take this flower and you can mash it together into a kind of poultice and mix it with an oil of some description, and then apply it to your skin. Or you can just take the flower and apply it directly to your skin. You gotta apply it forcefully and do it in a small area at first to make sure it doesn't irritate you. But this earthy smell that it has will repel biting insects. Now, there is the slight drawback that it will attract the occasional fly, but it's certainly worth trying if you're interested in primitive skills. One more thing I want to say about pollination in the black cohosh. When bumblebees pollinate black cohosh, they use a technique called sonification, which is where they vibrate their wings to release the pollen for them to gather. So they're actually using vibration to do it, which I think is kind of an interesting thing. It's a little too cool this morning for us to have many bees where I could point out the way that this happens. But as we get later in the day and the temperatures come up, more insects will be active. Thank you.